Howdy folks, Night Shift 10,000 here with another Night Shift 10,000 quickie. And this is a response video to someone who made a critique of my anarcho-communism is an oxymoron video. Apparently this someone, who I'm simply going to refer to as Sir Snowflake, became butthurt and took offense to my opinions in that video, and decided to make a humiliating failed attempt at discrediting it, even hilariously commenting in that video that he couldn't imagine getting triggered over an opinion or belief that isn't his, right before getting triggered over an opinion and belief that wasn't his. Now, I'm not going to go through the whole video that he made and subject you to an ass-numbingly long response like he did, so I'm just going to bullet point his criticisms and lay out how this individual fails at debunking really anything in that video. So, on that note, let's dive in.
To be an anarcho-communist.
So you see, like, the unnecessary maturity level of this guy? Like, this guy's supposed to be an adult. Like, why can't we debunk people's ideas without shitting on them?
Oh, suck it up, Buttercup. It's called the real world. Grow a pair, be a man, and stop downing all the soy, or get the fuck out of fucktown. And hold up, let's go back. Unnecessary maturity? Really? Do you just have bad word comprehension and not understand how to put words together in cohesive statements or something? Actually, that question gets answered later on in the video as Sir Snowflake here clearly fails to put my words and points into any cohesive meaning whatsoever. So, yeah.
There is no state in anarcho-communism. It's the workers who make all the decisions.
And this is what I'm talking about right here. I went over this point in the video several times, and he clearly ignores it or couldn't comprehend what was being stated. Anarcho-communism has a government through direct democracy, and that government forms a state.
That's already strike one with you. You don't even know that anarcho-communism doesn't even have a state in it. In fact, communism is indeed a political theory derived from Karl Marx, advocating class war and leading to a society in which all property is publicly owned and each person works and is paid according to their abilities.
Yes, and who enforces that? Oh, that's right, a government and a state enforces that. What do you think publicly owned means?
Notice how that definition said nothing about a state, right? Well, check out this definition right here. Communism, a political, philosophical, social, political, economic ideology and movement whose ultimate goal is the establishment of a communist society, namely a socioeconomic order structured upon the ideas of a common ownership of the means of production in the absence of social classes, money, and the state.
The definition in communism's case doesn't really matter because, in practice, communism has never worked the way it was laid out by Marx. I was going to cover this in a later video, but there's no time like the present, I guess. Communism is literally unachievable, as Marx himself advocated that a government through dictatorship of the proletariat would come into existence after the revolution and control public affairs in the new communist society, and then somehow magically evaporate, even though Marx himself gave little to no explanation as to how that was supposed to realistically happen. And historically, when has a council government with no restrictions on it ever surrendered power back to the people? Do you even understand basic human nature? Power corrupts, especially absolute power, and the dictatorship of the proletariat would have just that. Communism's definition is moot, as it's all about deeds, not words in this case. If you fail to understand human nature and history this much, you shouldn't be making shitty political videos, much less be a politician. And yeah, I looked on this guy's Facebook, and Sir Snowflake here is apparently a politician. God help us.
Definition.
Where is anarchy?
Because anarchism originated in left-wing ideology, buddy. It's always been socialist and Marxist ideology that has been the origins of libertarianism. For example, so this is left libertarianism. This is from Wikipedia. Now, right, where does it say? Right here. Although libertarianism in the United States has become associated with classical liberalism and minarchism, with right-wing libertarianism being more known than left libertarianism. Political usage of the term until then was associated with exclusively with anti-capitalism, libertarian socialism, and social anarchism, and in most parts of the world, such an association still predominates. So, you know what that means? That means libertarianism, aka anarchism, originated in left-wing ideology. Now, you could have used the argument that, oh, well, terms change and terms are different. Well, no. I mean, one, in theory, I mean, you can't have a system that only gives you your personal freedom and not your economic freedom. Otherwise, you're leaving people to be as stupid and ignorant as they possibly can. And two, majority of libertarians in the world are left-wing or center-left. So you can't just change the definition of something just because it doesn't fit your narrative.
Well, sort of. Anarchism actually originated with prehistoric humanity living in clan groups. If you're talking about the anarchists of the 1800s, then yes, they made the attempt to make anarchism a left libertarian ideology. The only problem was they could never merge their ideology with Marxism. They tried, but never found a way to do it. Only when good old Petey Crowpot came along with his magical unicorn ideology was this ever acknowledged, even though it was false. Now, if you're going to reference Pierre-Joseph Proudhon, who was the first to use the term anarchism, then I've got some bad news. Proudhon was one of the most misunderstood individuals in history, and people like you love to quote mine him with his famous property is theft line. Only problem is, he was speaking in context to state-sanctioned property ownership, and he even abandoned anarchism for his own brand of anarchism called mutualism. In recent years, it has simply been recognized that anarchism shares more in common with right libertarian or individualist ideology than it does left libertarian collectivist ideology. And no, throughout the world, right libertarians outnumber left libertarians. Hate to break it to you.
Ideology at its very core.
The campaign was not just against...
You see, you kind of know they don't know anything about communism or anarchy when they bring up Mao or Stalin or Hitler. As I've shown you guys earlier, I've shown you the definition of communism. I've shown you what libertarianism is. Now, let me show you another definition. Authoritarian socialism, or socialism from above, is an economic and political system supporting some form of socialist economics while rejecting political liberalism. As a term, it represents economic political systems describing themselves as socialist and rejecting the liberal democratic concepts of multi-party politics, freedom of assembly, habeas corpus, and freedom of expression, whether due to fear of the counter-revolution or as a means to socialist ends.
Okay, what I was doing there was illustrating how communist revolutions go down in real life. I never referenced Hitler. However, Stalin, or Lenin at least, and Mao used communism as a means to achieve their goals, which resulted in authoritarian socialism. My point was that that's how communist revolutions go down, and the realistic outcome to a communist revolution is always stacked bodies and either quote-unquote anarcho-communism or authoritarian socialism.
Now, even the definition, by definition, Mao, Stalin, those people were not real communists.
Oh, I didn't think he'd do it, but he did it. He pulled a not real communism, guys. And again, it's about deeds, not words. I'm sure that many communists throughout history have tried to live up to the definition, but every time communism has been tried, and every time it will be tried, it has always and will always end in disaster.
They were far right-wing extremists.
They were leftists, dude.
Who banned free speech and murdered millions of people. These people don't give a damn about communism. And I don't think you'll hear Hitler, Stalin, or Mao talk about anarchy or libertarianism.
Of that, I have no doubt. Never once said that they would.
I mean, for God's sakes, Mao believed in peasantry. That is totally against communism.
Dude, seriously? Did you just say that unironically? What in the high holy hell do you think the proletariat are?
Or anarchy, for that matter. So, you're just wrong on that.
Dude, what the fuck? That was an enormous straw man you just made right there. You completely straw-manned my argument. No, I never said that. I never said anything to that conclusion. My point was simply this. Communist revolutions always end in massive amounts of dead, innocent people and an authoritarian state either way. Wow. Okay, honestly, dude, I think you should reconsider debating anyone out there, much less myself, if all you can make are outlandish straw man fallacies.
When we're talking about actual anarchy, when we're talking about actual anarcho-communism...
Make a distinction between one or the other, because they're not the same thing.
We're talking about Catalonia, Spain, where they seized the means of production and all the workers voted under direct democracy about what's distributed and what is produced.
Can you hear what you're saying right now? Can you comprehend the statement? Direct democracy is a form of government. Enforced, that means through force or compulsion, by the commune and the majority. It goes completely against anarchism.
In direct democracy, the workers, no rulers, no masters, no state.
Except for the commune majority, they were the state, government, and rulers. They could overpower the minority. You've got to be kidding me that you're not getting this.
It was the workers. And under Catalonia, Spain, they were able to get adequate healthcare, adequate education.
That is debatable. It hinges on your definition of adequate.
You could basically get whatever you needed. You needed to go to the barbershop, you can go for free. You need to go to doctors, you can go for free. It was that simple.
Now he is going to ignore the part where in revolutionary Catalonia there were labor camps. The commune forced certain people to fight on the front lines and didn't supply them with weapons because factory workers wouldn't work the factories. People were executed for having differing political beliefs and even the unforgivable crime of carrying around money, and how essential workers like doctors, educators, and soldiers were pressed into labor and forced to work while other people were not forced to work and didn't have to. Quote-unquote anarcho-communism has the same principles of forcing some people to work for free with no compensation while others don't have to work. Wait,
that just sounds like slavery with extra steps.
Poverty was non-existent in Catalonia, Spain.
Because they stole the subjugated labor of others and called it free.
And you have anarcho-syndicalism to this day working in places like Chiapas, Mexico, with the Zapatistas.
I've made the point before that anarcho-syndicalism is just a rebranded representative Republican government, again, with extra steps. Syndicates are unstable as hell and rarely last long. Plus, the movements that do exist either live in dirt-poor conditions with no real advancement or are close to collapse even now as we speak. The longest-lasting being the Zapatistas, who are still dirt-poor and have barely accomplished anything for their movement.
They have sustainable agriculture, same, adequate healthcare and education.
Again, double check your definition of adequate there.
They're doing fine as well. So, yes, although you might see history has shown people have used socialism for their own personal gain, by definition, and by the way they ruled, it is not real it is not real communism by its own very definition.
Yet it is the end result of every attempted communist society out there. Well, most of them that don't result in anarcho-communism, which is an oxymoron even still.
No. Anarcho-capitalism has a hierarchy because you're basically replacing the state with corporate tyranny.
Okay, I've explained several times in past videos, and even in the one that's being highlighted, how free market and anarcho-capitalism are not corporatism. Corporations require the government to exist. Corporations need the government to exist. Without the government and the laws and regulations it provides, corporations could not exist. In genuine laissez-faire free market anarcho-capitalism, it would just be small and large businesses with voluntarist individual interactions all the way through. That's it. Nothing more.
It doesn't matter if it's voluntary or not. I mean, I choose to shit in a toilet bowl, but that's because I have no other option. If you don't work, you die. That's basically how that goes.
Well, actually, no. If you're rich enough in an ANCAP society, you don't have to work.
Everything's gonna be more expensive, too. Sure, you're gonna get rid of the income tax, but it doesn't take into account that, oh great, now I have to pay for my kids' education, K through 12.
Well, yeah, there's no such thing as a free lunch, and there shouldn't be for that matter. Besides, I've explained in this video, I might add, how prices would decrease exponentially and how incomes for everyone would increase drastically. And you called me dishonest for stating the facts, even though the statistics and evidence agree with me.
K all the way up to 12, so now I'm going to be in $500,000 in debt because my kid has to go to school. He has to work his way up somehow.
Again, prices in a stateless free market society would drop through the floor and be valued by a competitive rate through the market.
So, yeah. I mean, there's really no difference between state tyranny and laissez-faire capitalism on the economic level.
Good Lord, you really made that argument unironically. Okay, moving on.
Even Murray Rothbard said you guys are not original anarchists.
Just because it's a newer form of anarchy doesn't mean it isn't anarchist. Okay, I've got something to confess right now. I am not going to be covering all of the excerpts. I'm not going to be covering all the points that this guy makes in this video because this video of mine is already getting way too long as it is. And frankly, I just don't have the patience to cover all of these things. Plus, this guy makes a lot of repeated points. So at this point, I'm pretty much just going to be covering the important material or what I view to be the important material.
And you're going to give me this bullshit that, oh, well, charity is just going to fix everything. Well, I'm sorry, you're wrong again. We couldn't even surpass $500 billion last year in charity.
$500 billion U.S. dollars is a lot, dude. Plus, statistically, it has been shown that without governments and taxes, not only incomes would increase 75% from what they are now, but rates of giving to charities would increase by 4 times their current rate. That's practically the equivalent of $2 trillion. How is that not adequate for the disabled and impoverished again?
Shit, even in socialist countries, just in socialist countries in general, there's been a study on this. They have better food, better healthcare, and better education. They have a higher calorie supply.
You need to do your research again and do it a little bit harder. Plus, the Scandinavian countries like Norway and Finland have asked repeatedly people like you not to count them as socialist because they're not purely socialist.
It's anarchist capitalism is because we end a government.
Yes, but you also totally disregard the fact that under your system, a lot of people are going to still be ruled by a hierarchy, which is the corporations.
Okay, I wanted to give this guy the benefit of a doubt, but he just can't comprehend words and statements. Wow.
Rights are not being violated.
He's making the argument that government and corporations have always gone hand in hand with, at the end of the day, having corporate welfare, having special tax exemptions, loopholes.
Do you not understand what a corporation is?
We'll blame monopolies on the government. The government didn't go to these corporations and say, hey, you're gonna have monopolies.
You have no idea how monopolies work, do you? Monopolies are upheld by the government through trade controls and regulation. Before the government got involved with the market, corporations didn't exist.
These corporations came to them first. So you have to blame it on, when you have a system like lobbying, then yes, capitalism is very flawed. Because now you have politicians making laws based on what corporations want.
I've never said once that capitalism is incorruptible. You have to remove that which makes something susceptible to corruption. Hence why ANCAPs like myself want to abolish governments. If we abolish governments, then corporations will fall.
So to pretend and act like it's just the government's fault is just not being honest. I mean, shit, I can be honest about it. You don't hear me saying, oh, it's just the corporations that did everything. No, both of them went hand in hand, so let's be honest here.
And now you strawman me again and claim I'm being dishonest when I never said it was purely the government's fault once. My point was government spearhead these programs. No, I'm not saying it was purely the government's fault leaving the corporations and companies that go along with these things out. You claim I'm being dishonest when we are actually saying the same thing here. Again, please learn word comprehension.
But notice how it's the government that ended slavery, not capitalism. You seem to forget that.
But do you notice that it was the government that started slavery and not capitalism? Yeah, you seem to forget that.
That's not how that works. They don't give you a sack of potatoes if you're a doctor. How it goes is, if you need your car fixed, go to the mechanic. The mechanic will help you.
Mechanical work for complex open-heart surgery. Truly a just compensation.
Seizing the means of production and making sure it's equally distributed amongst everybody. I mean, for God's sakes, we have enough money in this country to give every man, woman, and child a $300,000 annual salary. Can you imagine all the wealth that all of us would have?
Yes. Then you redistribute everyone's wealth, people stop caring and do sloppy work, if any work at all, because there's nothing higher to work towards or to strive towards, income value goes down, money rates go down, and before you know it, we're living in a shithole with no money at all. And wait a minute, you're defending anarcho-communism. I thought you were against money being used.
You bastards! Well, no, you notice how you didn't actually go after the actual argument. He didn't say anything about not being able to work wherever you want.
Because given from actual historical examples of anarcho-communist societies that have existed in the past, people were usually assigned to work a certain profession or were told what to do by the commune.
Useless thing that focuses on what is of value and forward-thinking ideals?
Yes, that's the problem. Innocent people suffer and innocent people die because helping people is not profitable.
Oh my God, you literally just made that statement unironically. Oh, fuck. Folks, he did it. He done did it. He broke me. I think that statement was so idiotic that it gave me cancer. I can feel the fucking tumors growing. Oh, okay. A lot to unpack here. So, innovation and advancement are problems. Lifting people out of backwards, archaic, and dangerous professions and way of life doesn't help them. It isn't profitable to lift people out of these conditions, even though it increases efficiency and brings a higher quality of life to everyone as a result. I have nothing to say. Dude, seriously? You need to re-examine your beliefs.
Capitalism.
Innovation doesn't just require capitalism. There are other ways people are there's other ways innovation happens.
Capitalism has brought the highest amounts of innovation and advancement to society in recorded history.
Another thing, too, in anarcho-capitalism, there is no law enforcement, really.
Have you never heard of private security that works better and more efficiently than public police?
Let alone a developed nation, Mr. Nightwatch.
And he accuses me of being childish. Good God, that wasn't even inventive. I'm not advocating for night watchman states. I'm an anarcho-capitalist. They're not the same thing.
Direct democracy is a key part of anarcho-communism, but democracy of any kind is still a government and forms a state, so it can't be anarchy.
It's not a government. It's a bunch of workers coming together to make the rules of society.
Dude, say that again. But slowly this time. This is where I'm going to call it. He again claims I'm being dishonest for stating the truth that governments are spearheading the problem with monopolies and allowing for corporations to play their corrupt games with society. But I've already addressed that, so it's not important. This was a lot to get through. I'm not going to be responding to this guy again if he makes another video about me, mainly because I don't think it would get through to him anyway. I am set to debate him soon, and I will be posting that on my channel, but that's another matter entirely. I just hope hope you guys learned something here, and I also hope you've gained an understanding for what I have to go through on a usual basis. Well, that's it for now. Peace out, guys.